Greetings, everyone. Hey, how you doing? It's Matt Sella here. Today, I want to do a quick review, and it's a non-spoiler review, for Laika's latest animated movie, Missing Link. Now, what's funny is, in the lineup of movies that I wanted to review, I tried to get tickets for this, but there was no listing for it in the local theaters near where I am. And it was also funny, I was supposed to see Hellboy as well, but no tickets available. And I was kind of glad I avoided that one, because, oh boy, I heard it was quite a stinker. But Missing Link, I definitely wanted to check out. And quick disclaimer here, the trailer does not really have the sense of tone the movie has in reality. And here's my quick theory on that. One of Laika's early films was Coraline, which was kind of Tim Burton-y first take on like the stop motion thing for that studio, I believe. And while I thought the movie was okay, it had to share its problems. It was kind of dark, eerie and all that, and I don't know how well it did at the box office. Following that, we had Paranorman, which kind of lines into the whole dark themes. I saw that, not in theaters, but on Netflix, and I thought it was a really well-made movie. I enjoyed it. Don't know if that did well either. Then Kubo and the Two Strings came out, and while that was a little bit lighter, still had some of those dark themes on it, I thought the story was fantastic. It was really well done. Visuals were amazing. Voice acting was spot on. It was just an all-around really good movie that I wish won Best Animated Feature of that year. But unfortunately, I don't think the box office did well, and I remember hearing news that Laika Studio was in trouble trying to make good profits off these movies, but with stories they wanted to continue to tell and be creative and push the boundaries of stop-motion animation. So then when Missing Link was first announced and I saw the teaser trailer, I was a little nervous that they may have had to cave in to what some people would call the Illumination Studio style of being safe, family-friendly films. It was much lighter than the previous three films that I've seen. Oh, and I forgot to mention Box Trolls. That was another one. Really well animated. I love the facial animation in that one. Kind of dark, maybe lighter and more silly, but still. Missing Link is definitely the lightest of the bunch. So that made me worried that maybe they're just going to have to stick to a generic story and play it safe a little bit. But truth be said, this movie was actually pretty well done. It was really good. I strongly recommend to anyone who is an animator, artist, or just someone who appreciates the visual medium, please go see this movie. The cinematography in this, the way they set up shots to establish the journey of our main characters going through the story, beautifully composited. The colors are lush. They are amazing. They are moody based off like the tone of wherever they are. Facial animations are once again spot on. Very well done. Stop motion animation. I remember hearing that they would model the faces in Maya, 3D print them, and then put them on the puppet rigs as they were shooting it. Combining the environments with sets as well as like 3D backdrops and all that kind of stuff. Really well done. Really great. But as far as the story goes, yes, I think the story was pretty good as well. Not as good as Kubo and Two Strings, in my opinion, but I had very little issues with really any of the characters. You have Hugh Jackman playing Sir Lionel Frost, the adventurer wannabe. Well, he is an adventurer, but he wants to join this club run by the guy named Lord Bigot Thunsby, played by the awesome Stephen Fry, which I didn't realize that until like near the end. Oh, posh, posh English gentlemen of adventurers, leaving their mark on the world. But this Sir Frost is no adventurer. Pah, pah, pah. And so Lionel Frost gets a lead on what could be the Sasquatch in the Washington state. And so wishes to prove that he is a true adventurer by gathering evidence of some sort to say, yes, the Sasquatch is real. And so he goes off to do that, while Lord Bigger is like, well, dang, I don't want you to be right. I'm right. You're wrong. Get rid of him or whatever. And so Lionel Frost quickly runs into Mr. Link, the Sasquatch Bigfoot guy, played by Zach Galifianakis. Can't believe I said that right on the first try. And so Zach, or as Mr. Link in this movie, of course, says that he is the only one left in his entire forest and hears of tales where other Bigfoots like him might exist, hence the Himalayas and the Shambhala, Shangri-La. The place goes by many names, and so he believes he will find brethren there, and so asks Mr. Lionel Frost to help him take him there, since he's heard great things about his tales while reading newspapers and stuff. And so the movie goes off from there. A buddy-buddy journey, adventure, to find missing Link's brethren in the Himalayas. And so what more could I say? I think it's a very simple story. It is kind of a story we've probably seen before many times, but I think it really comes down to the character dynamics the fun adventure. And don't get me wrong, these characters are not flawless, mind you. Sir Lionel Frost, I ain't gonna lie, he's kind of a self-centered jerk. That's pretty established at the beginning of the movie. But it's about that whole journey about what it means to make a name for yourself, to stand out and be part of something, but also learning how to accept a friend and to care for somebody, while Mr. Link is just yearning to belong somewhere, to not feel alone. And that resonates with a lot of people, all of you for sure, myself included. We just want a sense of community, to be welcomed, to belong. So I think there's great character strength foundation right there. There is a little bit of a tongue-in-cheek going on. The movie does have an overall Western vibe to it in most cases. But I think, again, what really stands out to me is just the visual establishment of their journey. There are a lot of montage in this, a lot of going from A to B to C to D. But the music that accompanies it, the visual cues, the establishing shots, how they merge together, the mapping, all that stuff. Honestly, I haven't felt this excited to be on adventure in a family film in a long time. I would gladly go see this again. I highly recommend it. Please check out The Missing Link. Again, if you're an animator, artist, art appreciator of the visual medium, what have you, I highly recommend it. Don't let the trailers fool you. Again, I will warn, this isn't as much of a kids movie as I expected. Things do get rather real. There are stakes involved. There is a lot of talking. There's a lot of conversing. All of that character interaction going on. I do remember there was this mother and her child who must have been like 5 or 6 or 7. Within the first 15 to 20 minutes, I kind of noticed the girl, she was getting very antsy to the point where eventually the mother decided to take her out of the theater. There was no scuffle or anything like that. I think the girl said she actually wanted to leave. And I guess that's a good threshold, I would say. Like, if you have kids like really young, like maybe 8 or younger, this movie might have a hard time retaining their attention. But if your kid's old enough to kind of like enjoy Indiana Jones or something like that with a little bit more lightheartedness to it, just slightly more, I think the kids are going to love it. And again, if you're an artist appreciator, I definitely think you're going to love it. As far as how the box office is, I haven't checked the numbers yet, and this is a late review technically, but something tells me this is going to be another, I'm not going to say bomb or flop, but it's not going to really do them any favors, I don't think. There's a lot of competition on the horizon. I wish more people would check this out. It's a really fun movie. I'd gladly go see it again. And so that's my recommendation to you. Go see The Missing Link. It's a lot of fun. The music, the visuals, all that good stuff. Like a magic, I'm telling you what. Hey, thanks for listening to this review. If you like content just like this, we also have other podcasts and things like that that I run. And if you want to support me, please consider going to patreon.com/Matt Sella. Donate as little as $1 a month. It'll really help me keep things going around here. Want to do more reviews, more podcasts, more discussions with friends and other guests. And by contributing in that way, helps me work towards that goal of bringing you guys more content. Also, be sure to check out my art on patreon.com/Matt Sella. I like to post drawings, fan art, commissions sometimes. Go there to check out some of my work. All right, guys, thank you all for tuning in.